Hello, my name is Visor, and welcome to episode 18 of Let's Play The Witcher 2. Last episode, we did a few bits from three different quests, and this episode, we're actually going to finish one of them, continue with a few more. First up, we need to talk to Dandelion at the inn.
A rhyme for wonder?
I'm no poet.
I know, but you have good ideas sometimes.
Yonder?
Good!
Writing a sonnet for your new muse?
Better than that. I'm composing an anthem for Vergen. Want to hear the first version?
No.
Listen. May those who dream of freedom arise, seeing the sight of liberty with their eyes. Let us go together, become our brother. The choice is yours, you know there's no other. How far shall we venture in this great wonder? Elf, dwarf, and human set forth together yonder. Like it?
It rhymes, kind of.
All right then, tell me what you discovered.
Seems so disappointed. Anyway, we can ask about all this other stuff, but I really just want to get along with the mission, so...
I found a volume of your poetry.
My love poems! Some bastard stole them recently. Probably wanted to show off to a young lass smelling of sheepskins. I really missed this book. It was like being in a brothel with no balls. I owe you one, Geralt, though I don't know quite how I'll repay you. No, actually, I do. Up for a shot of vodka? It's on me.
I've got a better idea.
Beer? That's fine. All the same to me.
I need you to do me a favor.
Name it. For this, I'd give you my chastity. If I still had it, of course.
I wouldn't be interested.
Don't tell me you need another poem for a noon wraith.
Worse.
Please, Geralt, don't get me involved in another messy monster matter. I'm an artist, not...
That's precisely who I need to lure a succubus.
Are you crazy? You want to see a hoofed hag ride me to death? On the other hand, we all have to die of something.
Go to the burned-down village after dark and wait for me there.
Honestly, I don't know why he's interested in that, but whatever. All right, let's go back to the burned-down village and wait till it's dark. All right, so this looks like midnight. So Dandelion should be here somewhere.
Can we go? I can't wait to meet this monstrous beauty.
Her beauty's killed several men.
Now you tell me.
Like my friend Dandelion says, we all have to die of something. I'll have my eye on you at all times.
So will she.
Don't let her kiss you.
I don't usually deny women foreplay, but I'll do my best.
Let's do this.
Well, how should we begin?
So this is based on his poetry. After all, that's how that youth got to the succubus, using his poems. If you read the book, you actually see it. I think it's the third poem. Anyway, it starts with...
If our bodies could a song compose...
First option.
My heart would inquire of your hands pale and fine, if they'd grasp it gently to hold like a rose.
And finally, a second option.
Or treat it as a morsel upon which to dine.
Who are you, gorgeous one?
I'm a poet, m'lady. I've come to praise your unearthly beauty, if you'll do me the honor of revealing your full self.
Indeed. I shall reveal to you all my splendors. Prepare more than your eyes. I am a feast for all the senses. Come with me for the adventure of your life, fair poet.
I should get Geralt. On the other hand, I've never plowed a succubus.
I am so unsatisfied. Lovers who compose poems praising my virtues. Delightful. But I've never had a true poet perform for me.
So over there, you can see Geralt really anxious and trying to help. We can go over there, call Geralt over. Or we can take Dandelion into the lair of a succubus. Because that's a good idea, right? Well, we'll see.
fucking idiot actually went in. I got him into this mess. I'd better get the fool out.
That's the main reason I do it, because I think it's funny. Now, don't worry about Dandelion. He'll be fine. Probably. Mostly. Anyway, let's keep on going. You'll notice, though, that this quest, for some reason, resets your adrenaline bar. I think it's because you were playing as Dandelion for a while and he doesn't have one, which is irritating, in my opinion. Anyway, let's just take this one out. There we go. I really should have done quick attacks, but whatever. Come on, let me down. There we go. You notice how the succubus had a weird undertone? Almost manly? Well, he's enjoying himself.
I don't remember inviting you, Geralt of Rivia.
Let Dandelion go.
You mean you won't join us? He's come to no harm. On the contrary, he seems very happy.
Yeah, I don't really get the whole hooves thing, but whatever. Whatever you're into, I guess. There's probably a Welsh joke in there somewhere, but I'm not from that area of the world, so I won't make it. Anyway, let's ask her about the others.
Like all the other men you murdered?
I've murdered no one. All who followed me experienced unearthly pleasures.
You devour their energy like a swine gobbles spuds.
I need their vital energies. I have no use for corpses.
What will you do with Dandelion?
I shall show you my intentions are pure. I'll release him when he wakes.
Then who is actually the murderer?
So if it wasn't you, who killed those young men?
I can seduce anyone and hold them spellbound for as long as I wish. Unfortunately, one fool fell madly in love with me. Unable to accept my nature, he's killing my lovers.
And his name is?
Who is this lover of yours?
A beautiful elf named Elias.
He asked me to investigate the murders.
His way of throwing you off his scent. Luckily, you're no fool.
The very reason I think you're trying to throw me off your scent.
Did he show you the victims' bodies?
He told me they were buried.
By him. Yet he massacred the corpses first to make it seem as if beasts had attacked the poor souls. I'm content to have you looking into the matter. Just be sure to see it through.
Okay, we can do that. And she sort of has a point. Can't steal energies from a dead body. But the fact that she can seduce him anyway, she doesn't really need to murder them. I mean, I understand sucking them dry, but eating the shit out of them, that doesn't really make sense for a succubus. But maybe I don't understand the mythology. Anyway, let's ask her a few more questions like, why should I help you?
Why should I help you?
I want men to know that I give pleasure in return for their energy. But I don't take their lives. Besides, I can give you something far better than Orange.
Interesting. So let's talk to Elias.
I'll talk to him, then I'll come back.
I hope we can seal our friendship then.
Alright, so let's go back, talk to Elias, maybe see his side of the story. And so far, it does make sense for her to not murder them. But at the same time, if Elias is just jealous of the other men, why would he ask us to investigate the murderers? Okay, so Elias is still just chilling here. Let's talk to him, see what he's got to say for himself.
I found the succubus.
Did you kill her?
She claims you're the murderer.
You were supposed to kill the monster, not chat with it.
I know what I'm supposed to do.
I don't think so, not if you believed her.
But he definitely lied to us, so definitely know that.
You lied to me. You knew a succubus had made its lair in the burned-down village.
I did. I thought you'd refuse to help me if I told you.
You're right. I don't help murderers.
That is pure nonsense. I killed no one.
Well, if he's just trying to get revenge on the lovers, yeah, it wouldn't make sense for him to make us investigate the murders. However, if he's trying to get us to kill the succubus, then it all makes sense. He's just really super jealous. Plus, it still doesn't make sense for the succubus to murder, so...
Liar. You fell in love with her and murdered your competitors. Succubi aren't exactly the most faithful partners.
True, I love her, but the rest is hogwash.
If I'd killed the succubus, no more men would have perished and you'd have gotten away with it.
You don't understand. She manipulated me like she's manipulating you.
Iorveth will learn of this. You'll hang for your crimes.
You're mad. I'm innocent.
Well, I'm getting some mixed messages here. On one hand, he says he loves her, but he pretty much admitted sending me to assassinate her. So, yeah, not sure I buy that story. Either way, let's go talk to Iorveth. Alright, so Iorveth is staying in this room here, so let's check it out. Ah, there he is. And if you look at his face, you'll sort of see why I said earlier that he'll probably scare the children. He took off his eye patch. Not sure why.
Greetings, Gwynblade.
I also don't get how he's an archer with only one eye. Like, don't you need depth perception, maybe? I don't know. Anyway.
Your Scoia'tael, Elias, is murdering people from Vergen.
Any proof? Elias is one of my best warriors.
I found a splinter from a blade in one of the bodies. Compare it to Elias's weapons.
I'll see to it. Elias must have learned that I know the truth about his madness. He's fled the city.
Well, that's unfortunate. Not much else we can do, though, so let's just go talk to the succubus, I guess. Though that conversation we had earlier with Elias didn't really matter. Regardless of whether we believed him or not, as soon as we tell Iorveth about the evidence, he's gonna flee the city. Battle prepared in there. Well, here we are again. Let's go tell the succubus that Elias ran away.
I'll not be put down like some dog! Fight!
Oh, there he is. That's convenient. Really should have ran. He does block a lot, which is kind of annoying, but we have a solution. Which is set him on fire. Oh, he's blocking again. More fire. Seriously, what can a single elf do to Geralt? There we go. That's a kind of a weird pose. Unfortunately, he doesn't actually drop anything. Oh well. Well, let's go down with the succubus. I mean, she should be appreciative. It'll help her reputation that she's not murdering people. Anyway, let's see what happens.
I'm pleased you put an end to that fool's torment. You'll be blissfully rewarded. Disrobe and relax.
Now, personally, when I saw this, I decided not to do it. Because one, she has goat hooves. And two, when she talked earlier, there was that really demonic undertone. I don't know, maybe if she kills a witcher, she gains immortality or something. God knows what goes on in this world. So I just went with another time. It doesn't really change the reward either way.
As tempting as others might find you, I think I'll pass. On the sex, of course. Got anything else for me?
Oh, what a shame. But it will be as you wish. In the box by the bed, I left you a small gift. Something to remember me by. Goodbye, Witcher.
Yeah, the demonic male voice undertone kind of is a turnoff. Definitely don't want to touch her. Just my personal preference. Anyway, in the crate we have some garbage, some gold, rook, which isn't bad, and some armor that's inferior to our current armor. So, really not a great haul. However, if we sided with Elias, we would get some loot off her body, which is decent value, as well as some gold from Elias, so we would actually end up with more orins overall. Ultimately, I guess it's up to you, but from my point of view, Elias was guilty and he needed to die. Just my opinion. Anyway, we still have some time left, so... You know, the game keeps telling me to talk to Philippa. I think I'll go talk to Philippa. Alright, so there's Philippa's house. However, we run into something a little interesting.
Mm. What is it, Witcher?
Who is that girl?
Cynthia, a leashed sorceress.
A charming expression. Do you also use muzzles?
Leash means a connection between a sorceress and her assistant. An unfortunate term, I admit, but it explains how things are. Cynthia can tap my power, use my spells. She's a conduit. And she's learning along the way. It's convenient, and except for the name, not derisive at all. But you're not here to talk about Cynthia.
No, we are not. Though, it's kind of interesting. Anyway, let's mainly talk about... Well, I kind of want to ask her about this other stuff too, but let's mostly talk about the quest stuff. So, we got the Immortelle, well, 2 episodes ago, so let's ask about that first.
I found an Immortelle.
Excellent.
And, yeah, that's about it. You still need to get the blood after all. Oh, we also found a magical crystal last episode.
I found one of the ingredients for Saskia's cure.
Show me. Interesting. Getting warmer, but still not there. It's as if I'd sent you to get me the sun and you'd brought me a candle. We need something massive, an item of real power, Geralt. This is a dwarf's dream. Stolen and magically encased in this crystal, it would do if it were stronger.
You know what this means? In addition to normal harpies, there are Solano in the area.
Solano?
Dream snatchers. The only harpy species to develop something resembling intelligence. They magically bind dreams to mountain crystals. I heard they once inhabited this area. Solano live among regular harpies, but their lair should be full of stolen dreams. One of those would be powerful enough, I'm sure.
You'd have to enter the harpy lair through the quarry. Unfortunately, the gate to the caves is locked and Cecil Burden won't open it. I asked him on another occasion. Stubborn as a mule, that one. But we must not relent. Saskia clings to life by a thread. Let me show you the desire contained in this particular dream. Don't be hasty to judge.
Yes, I can feel it. Whose dream is it?
Cecil Burden's.
In that case, I need to see the Alderman. Got a feeling he just might open the gate for me.
Interesting. Let's keep talking to him.
You wanted to discuss something.
Yeah, we got plenty to discuss. Let's ask about that curse as well.
At the council, you mentioned artifacts were needed to undo the curse.
But I can't look for them now.
I can do that.
Why?
I have my reasons. Tell me something.
Okay, so we got a bunch of questions we had to ask.
What happened here 3 years ago?
Henselt attacked Edirne, but met his match. Nobody won that war. Sabrina Glefisig got into a conflict with the commander-in-chief of the Kedwenni forces, and this led to both armies being routed. Fireballs turned the battlefield into a flaming tomb. Henselt accused Sabrina of using a forbidden weapon.
And Sabrina cursed Henselt.
I think so. I suspect the curse got out of hand because of the circumstances.
Circumstances? The stars weren't right, wrong phase of the moon. There's always an excuse for simple bungling.
She placed the curse while burning at the stake. Her hands and feet nailed to a wagon wheel. I'd say she did a good job considering.
Okay. Well, let's ask about the ghosts.
Did you notice? Not all the ghosts were aggressive.
Yes. Most just disappeared when they touched the aura of a living person.
I think the curse corrupts the ghosts of the fallen and turns them into draugrs.
Is that the Witcher's professional name for wraiths?
Draugrs are demons of war. They arise at sites of exceptionally vicious, bloody battles. Their bloodlust and hatred in condensed form.
Can you kill them by conventional means?
A silver sword is enough for a draugr, but as long as the curse remains active, new ones will arise. The soldiers' ghosts are the key. If I could turn the tide of the battle...
For that you'll need symbols of war belonging to those who fell in battle. Hatred, death, courage, and faith. All artifacts must be magically active and connected to the fallen, or they won't lure the ghosts.
Right. I'll look around.
Finding two will be enough. Get the symbols of hatred and death and leave the rest to me.
I'd prefer courage and faith.
Don't fuss.
I'll see what I can do. Cecil seems to know a lot about the area.
Okay. So we actually already have the symbol for death. That's the Dung Banner standard. Well, no, that's... Yeah, that's death. As for hatred, we sort of need to get, well, Saskia better. So we'll work on that. Anyway, what about blood curses?
Know anything about blood curses?
Do you?
We're dealing with a fourth level curse, also known as the Curse of the Archmistress.
Well, well. I'm impressed.
Thing is, until now I thought it was only a myth that such a curse couldn't be cast.
You thought wrong. There are 6 confirmed cases of this curse being inflicted.
What about confirmed cases of it being lifted?
1. Achieved by a team of sorcerers led by Archmistress Francesca Finderbear, hence the curse's other name. Sabrina Glevesig was on the team.
Small world.
That's not all. The curse investigated by Francesca and Sabrina was designed to end the Tyson dynasty, the rulers of Kovir. They were cursed by Scarlet Rodelega, a complete madman, but very talented. An eclipse and wraiths also accompanied his curse.
So Sabrina's curse is just a knockoff Rodelega.
Exactly.
Can Francesca's experience help us?
Certainly. I know the symbols and the workings of the curse thanks to her.
Care to explain? I'm the one risking my neck.
You'll have to relive the battle and change its course at the right moment. I don't know exactly what will happen. Nobody does.
Huh. I'll look for those artifacts. I'm good for now. I'll let you know when I learn something.
All right, that pretty much covers everything I want to talk about. I mean, yeah, there's still the matter of Triss, but we'll have plenty of chances of talking to Philippa later on anyway. For now, though, we need to talk to Cecil. Well, next episode. Though I'm not quite done with this episode yet. There's one last thing I want to do. So what actually happens if you decide to take up the succubus on her offer? Again, I still think it's a bad idea, but I figure I might as well show it off. I assume you're curious.
In the box by the bed, I left you a small gift. Something to remember me by. Goodbye, Witcher.
So it ends up being pretty much what you should expect from a succubus, I guess. Guess she's fairly honorable and all that. In terms of reward, you get the exact same reward. Only other difference is the screen's kind of woozy because you're kind of drunk from her stealing your energy. But other than that, everything else is pretty much the same. Anyway though, that's it for this episode. I hope you liked this video and we'll come back next time, and of course, thank you very much for watching.